हेलो, okay.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Let's start quickly with some small questions. Can anybody from your side tell me what are the different types of business we have in India? Business established that we have in India. Can anybody become MBAs?
Small scale business, scale.
Okay. No, I'm not asking about the large scale or SME, small and medium scale. I'm just asking types of patterns, what types, what business you have, business establishments, under what are the types of what are the patterns we have. Businesses are established or registered. Can you just tell me about? Manju?
This outsourcing companies and real estates.
No, it's basically, if you do not know, also have a proprietorship concern. Then cross comes concern. Then we come across HUF, Hindu Undivided Family. Then we come across Private Limited, Public Limited, Cooperative Societies. Right? Now, proprietorship concern is a single owner business established and owned by a staff, operated by a single owner. He is the whole and soul. Comes to partnership business. When 200 people invest together based on percentage of investment profit. Okay. Next, private limb. Tell me, what are the minimum number of directors in private limited? Mute yourself and be active. Try to answer. Doesn't matter if it's right or wrong. Your involvement, you're making an effort to answer, matters.
I think 6 members.
6 members minimum. It is 6. Rajesh.
At least 2.
Who is this? Srihari.
Yes, sir.
Srihari says 2. Anyone else has to say anything else?
Two.
Karthik is right. Srihari is right. Minimum number of directors is 2 in private limited. What is the maximum number, guys? Can anybody?
50.
Maximum 200. I think
253.
Okay.
A private limited company can have, or it can be created by minimum 2 directors and maximum 253 directors. Clear?
Yes.
What about public limited company? Minimum number of, maximum number of directors.
Minimum number of directors, like 3. I'm not sure.
Okay. Karthik says 3. Anyone else has to add up? Manju, Rajesh, Srihari, Nidhi.
I think again 2, sir.
What is that?
2, I think, in even public limited.
Public limited also 2, Srihari says. Manju, Rajesh, any contribution?
No.
No. In public limited company, minimum number of directors is 7. Minimum number of directors is 7. And what is maximum, guys?
Maximum unlimited, I think.
Yes, right answer. Absolutely right answer. Minimum number of directors 7 and maximum is unlimited. Okay. Clear?
Yes, sir.
What is the major difference between public limited and private limited? What is the major difference?
Government will be involved in public limited.
Who says that? Srihari.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Government will be involved in public limited. Okay. Yeah. And private limited?
Individual.
individuals are involved. There is no government involvement. That's what Srihari has to say. Srihari, what you are mistaken is good you spoke, because there is room for correction and rectification that increases your knowledge, and it will help you somewhere in interview and working places as well. What you said, Srihari, is public sector, not public limited. There is a difference between public limited and public sector. We come across two things. One is public limited, private limited. Another one is public sector, private sector. If it comes to private sector, as you said, it's independent individual directors who come together and form a company, wherein there is no involvement of either a state government or central government or any government body. That is private sector. When it comes to public sector, 51% share, 51% ownership belongs to central government. Listen carefully, 51% ownership belongs to central government, 49% belongs to private directors, that is private individual directors. Okay, so the thing is, I'll give you some examples. Now, we had a sale, we had a bail, we have IDBI Limited, right? IDBI is the best example. Earlier, it was a private limited company. Yes. Sorry, guys. Earlier, it was a private limited company. When I was working in 2005-06, in IDBI Limited as a senior officer, and all of a sudden we got a news that it has become government. It is going to be declared as a public sector government company. That's government bank. So 51% ownership would be of government, central government, and 49% belongs to private directors or private owners. So, Srihari, is it clear what is public sector, what is private sector?
Yes, sir.
Public sector, public limited is different. Public limited is purely individual ownership, private ownership only. Just like Reliance, Tata's, Ambani's, these are all public limited, but they are not public sector. Government cannot enter into Ambani's business and say, do this. Because government doesn't have any stake in Ambani's business or Adani's business. Yeah, government can ask them to follow the rules which are levied by Taxation Department, Companies Act, District Industrial Centers or Chamber of Commerce. All these things, yes, I agree. They cannot cross the boundaries. They have to be in the boundaries. They have to follow the laws, rules and regulations, and do their business as per commercial and legal requirement. Commercial IAS, they have to maintain accounts as per IAS, Indian Accounting Standards, legal IPC, Indian Penal Code, right? So this is how it works.
Yes.
Public limited is different. Public sector, have a clarity now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, the major difference between the major difference between the private limited and the public limited. Private limited cannot accumulate funds or cannot raise funds from the public. public limited can raise funds from the public, common public. Okay, that is through shares, by issuing shares in the share market. Okay, we have three markets in India. What are those in equity market? Hello? Hello?
NSE, BX.
Yes, yes, right answer. NSE, BSE and Nifty. NSE, National Stock Exchange.
I'm getting a nice.
Stock Exchange, Hello?
Hello?
My neighbor's dog is barking, man. It's irritating here, actually. Sorry for the disturbance. Yeah, please come back again. Someone was answering something. Hello?
Yeah,
NSE, BX. What is that?
BX, Bombay Stock Exchange.
Okay. BSC, Bombay Stock Exchange. NSE, National Stock Exchange. And the third one is Nifty.
Yeah.
Okay? Okay, so public limited can issue shares, private limited cannot, does not have authority to do so. Now, can anybody tell me what is company, definition of company? All are BCom guys.
Company is
called
commercial business.
Company is? Commercial business. Company is a commercial business. Anyone else? Add up, guys. Okay. Company is commercial
business.
It's a legal entity. Okay, right answer. The right add up. Anyone else? Anything? Nothing?
No,
legal entity, commercial business. What is that?
Group of individuals.
Arctic says group of individuals coming together for business.
Yes.
Okay. Listen, guys. I will tell you what is company.
Okay.
Company is a business organization. Okay. Company is a business organization for which separate financials are drawn. Company is a business organization for which separate financials are drawn as per the commercial and the legal requirement of the country. Okay, guys, just give me 1 minute,
standing.
Yeah, guys, I'll come back again. Can you hear me? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Company is a business organization. Company is a business organization for which corporate financials are drawn as per the commercial and the legal requirement of the country. Company is a business organization for which separate financials are drawn as per the commercial and the legal requirement of the country. Now, what is the accounting principle we are using in India, guys? What is the accounting? Yeah, Karthik?
Sorry, sir, I didn't hear you what you said.
What is the accounting principle that we are using in India? Manju, Rajesh, Srihari, Nithi.
Maintain financial years April to March.
Yeah, and that is yes, financial year. It begins on April, ends on March. Agreed. But what is the accounting principle that we are using in India?
Like principles
balance
are
sheet and profit.
Any one person answer at a time. Hello?
Sir, it's principles or principles?
Accounting principles. Accounting principles I'm asking about. What is the accounting principle? What is the accounting rule, law which we use? Now, little earlier I said IPC, right?
Yeah.
What is IPC? Indian Penal Code.
Yeah.
Now, you commit a crime, you do a robbery, someone does a robbery, someone commits a murder, okay? There is IPC. We say 302, 307, 301, okay? 264, 258, check bounce, there's that. There are many IPC that generally we come across. If not directly, at least through Hindi movies, right? Hindi or Kannada movies, whatever movies you watch. Alright, so likewise IPC, what is the accounting principle that we use?
Gap.
What
ICA,
are accounts? What is that?
Gap.
ICA.
It's a gap. Who said gap?
Srihari
says gap. What is that?
ICAI.
ICNI.
AI.
ICAI. What is ICAI, Karthik?
I think Indian Chartered Accountant is that is true. I'm not sure.
Indian Chartered Accountant Institute, that is for CAs. Anyway, good effort. Gap. Srihari said gap. Srihari. We are not in US, we are in India, because America uses GAAP.
Okay.
What you said is correct, but America uses GAAP. Accounting principle of America is GAAP, GAAP, Generally Accepted Accounting Principles.
One more,
okay?
Is IFRS.
Yeah, IFRS is used by international community, that is MNCs, multinational companies, which operates simultaneously in all the countries of the world. They fall into category of IFRS.
Okay.
IFRS stands for International Financial Reporting or Regulatory System, both one and the same. Now, what we use in India is IAS, Indian Accounting Standards. What we use in India is IAS, Indian Accounting Standards. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. These are basics, guys. Don't miss out. Because in interview, it will either create your image or damage your image. Because what they look for, financial consultant or a SAP consultant. They expect you to be thorough with accounts, thorough with finance, and then IT part, SAP. Because once you grow to senior level, you will be directly having a meeting with a finance manager, vice president finance, senior vice president finance. And when you sit with someone like this, who belongs to Reliance or Big Bazaar or ICICI or some big company, you know their depth of knowledge, they'll be thorough. But be it accounts or be it finance, they'll have in-depth knowledge and experience of 20, 25, 30 years. When you will be facing such guys, right from the basic till the top, everything, your knowledge matters. If you do not have knowledge, you will not be able to understand what are they talking in technical terms. Understood?
Yes.
Okay. So it's very clear that we use IAS in India, Indian Accounting Standards. We use GAAP, that is US Generally Accepted Accounting Principles. We use GKB in Germany. We use IFRS for international standards. Then likewise, different companies, they follow different, UK has UK GAAP, US has US GAAP. And we all fall into this category. Now, for example, Tata, Reliance, Wipro, these are all Indian MNCs. Reliance, these people follow IFRS, Indian International Financial Regulatory System. Now, come back to definition. Company is a business organization for which separate financials are drawn as per the commercial and the legal requirement of the country. Okay. Company is also known as a client or a parent company because its associates or a sister concerns are going to be connected with it. That's a, in short, you can define company. Now, can anybody among you tell me what is company code? If company is this, then what is company code? Company code is nothing but, it's a subunit of a parent company. Now, what is subunit of a parent company? Now, Tata Industries Limited. When we talk about Tata Group, we say Tata Industries Limited. Okay? What is a subordinates or a subunits? Subunits are Tata Cement, Tata Motors, right? Subunits are Tata Steel.
Tata Steel.
Yeah. You have TCS also in IT. So we have many. Tatas are into everything, right? From salt, steel, aeroplane. Tata is into every business in India. Be it Tatas, Ambanis, these people have covered the market since from the independence. These people got into business and they understood the idea of business and they developed business like anything. And today they are a giants, business giants in India. Now at today's date, you start a business, you will not become Tata. Very difficult. Otherwise, you'll have to have a brains like Elon Musk, right? Then only it is possible. Otherwise, it's not possible. You need generation to grow to that level. Now, company is parent company and the company code, we talk about subunits or the sister concern of the same parent company. Is that clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And guys, I asked you yesterday something. I asked you to take access to server. Have you guys done it?
Access to server, sir.
Hello?
No, sir. I informed to Diya, but she's not responding, sir. Till.
Okay. Might be there is some technical team. There is some problem, or maybe the person is working on it, whatever may be reason. Let's see. So guys, any questions, any doubts? Feel free. Don't restrict yourself saying that five members are there. What if I ask a wrong question? What if I give a wrong answer? Sorry guys, all of you guys are Indian, very much Indian, no NRI in this. Okay, so I believe all of you know Chanakya.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
You know, right? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
okay.
Sir.
Yes, yes.
Chanakya says one thing. Chanakya says one thing in his different books. He has written one thing. When you come to learn, you should become like a small child. What I mean to say, what he means to say small child is, keep your self-respect, your ego, your all that status, belief, feeling, all that feeling of I know something, or I'm a graduate, or I'm a PG, postgraduate. Keep all that things at home. Empty yourself, and sit at the feet of learning. So when you sit and learn like that, I mean, when you make your mindset like that, the real learning begins. If you are shy, you cannot learn everything in this world. Because let me tell you one thing, no one has learned from the womb of a mother, right from the birth. Nobody knows everything. Everyone has to come in this world and learn things, maybe through books or trainers or teachers or some of the other sorts. But we have to learn, we have to grab knowledge, okay? So that knowledge will give us growth in our careers, right? Otherwise, we cannot grow. Can we grow without knowledge?
Yes.
We cannot, right?
Yes.
That's how it is. Especially in SAP, I'll tell you one practical thing. You have knowledge, nobody can stop you. You don't have knowledge, people will not even bother you. Nobody will, if you are working on the same project, people will run behind the people who have a knowledge because they get to learn. Otherwise, you come across the same team member right in front of you, they'll not even say good morning to you. Maybe you might have a personal friendship and people might respect you and people might have a good attachment, involvement with you. Agreed. But if it is at a professional phase, if it is at the professional end, you are respected only when you have a knowledge. Without knowledge, nobody respects you because you don't have a growth. You don't grow. You're stagnant. You're stagnant. You yourself will get frustrated one day. Maybe you, I'm with a 13 years experience here, almost 8-9 years into banking and last 5 years into SAP. You guys might be 2 years, 3 years. Some are 5 years. Some are 6 years, 8 years. So from my personal experience in corporate, I tell you that, yes, I have worked in a banking sector. I'm working in an IT sector. Knowledge matters. Be it you are in a conference room or you are in a meeting room or you are in a discussion of some idea or project or anything, your knowledge gives you that image or that exposure in front of your boss or your super boss or whatever, your team members, colleagues, everything. Okay? So what I advise you is develop it. If you do not know, ask. do not hesitate to ask questions. When I say any doubts, questions. No need of thinking that what others will think if I ask a wrong question. No need of thinking that what others will think if I give a wrong answer. What about my image? No. If you think about image, you cannot build image further in life. But if you give up on that, you can go on growing in life. Okay? So any doubts, any questions? Yes?
No, sir. I don't have anything.
As of now, no. Right?
No,
understood
yeah.
Everything.
Yes.
Understood yeah. Everything. Okay. So guys, we'll meet up tomorrow. Okay. Good. If it is with a login ID. So partially it will become theoretical and partially it will become practical. So we can enter, we can log in into software.
Yes.
Then we can learn, start learning the right from basic configuration. Okay.
Okay.
So if you do not have any questions.